So I think it's clear from multiple different studies from different groups that achieving MRD negativity as opposed to not is associated with better outcomes in terms of progression-free survival and overall survival. What is not known is if treatment decisions should be driven by MRD negative status and how much should that matter. So that's something that's being actively evaluated. At our center at MSKCC, we do test MRD status at patients at different time points. We do that at the end of induction, we do that at the end of transplant, and during follow-up at maintenance. And we use both flow cytometry-based MRD testing as well as next-generation sequencing-based MRD tests. We do think that this provides valuable prognostic information. We use it on a case-by-case basis to determine whether treatments need to be tailored. For instance, for patients who achieve MRD negativity after induction, we do give them the option of collecting their stem cells and deferring a consolidative autologous transplant to the time of relapse. This is obviously not established based on large randomized studies yet, but emerging evidence would suggest that this is a reasonable strategy for at least a select group of patients with newly diagnosed multiple myeloma. There are ongoing studies currently evaluating this strategy as well as others. For instance, what if a patient is MRD negative consistently for 3 years on maintenance? Is that a patient that can come off of maintenance therapy safely or needs to be on indefinite maintenance therapy? So that's something that will need clinical trials to answer, and those studies are being designed or ongoing currently.